Hello, my name is Gabrielle DeLaGarza. I'm here to do Sagittarius's reading. I do not own any of the music that is playing, so I'm just gonna throw that out there. And Sagittarius, why are you so pissed off? Off. I don't say off, I say off. But why are you so pissed off? I feel like you are so aggravated, like beyond aggravated, like not typically, not like a typical Sag. Like usually you guys just like go with the flow and are like, whatever, I'm mad, but I'm over it, I'm mad, but I'm over it. Like right now you're harboring something. Why so, Sagittarius? Why are you harboring something? Are you gonna tell me? Is it a relationship? Is it work? Is it both? You don't want to talk about it. You're that mad about something that you don't even want to talk about it. You don't want to bring it up. You don't want to tell anybody about it. You're just pissed. I don't know if you're taking it out on people or not. You're contemplating what's going on. You're not used to feeling this way. I feel like you're overly emotional right now. And I feel like you are fighting to be different because people are continuously, I want to use the word comparing, but that's too not unique. Like, just always comparing you to somebody else, but you're not. You're so different, Sag. I feel like you're finding yourself. All right, so let me just tell you this. First of all, I clairvoyant read. So I have cards, I love the cards. I use it as like in addition to's or clarifiers, but for the most part, like I get my energy reads through energy, like comes to me and out to you. So much easier that way. You're not confused, but like something's disappointing to you, whether it's a person or a thing. Like something is just like not up to par to what you want it to be. You're like, this is not what I want. I don't think people realize that Sagittarius has a standard. Like, there's a standard. There's a big standard. And it's funny, because for Aries, I wasn't wearing these glasses, but for Sagittarius, I had to wear them. Like, I needed to, like, put on my intellectual face and say, okay, how are we going to analyze the situation? How are we going to go into this? Sagittarius, you're very spiritual. Which we all already know. Which means you already have this overlooking of the other signs. But I think what needs to happen is you need to realize there's an equality between everybody. Right, like trying to override a Virgo or an Aquarius is going to be very hard because they're also intellectual. So I feel like coming to an understanding that there's intellectuality, if that's even a word, between a Sagittarius and an Aquarius, or between a Sagittarius and a Virgo, or between a Sagittarius and a Gemini, is very good conversation. You're very serious right now, Sag. I want to say Sag because I feel like it's serious. Like, there's no time for games, no time for in-betweens. Strictly business. And I can appreciate that. I feel like you need to relax. I feel like you need to realize that, like, if you're too serious right now, you're gonna regret it. Something about regretting the way you're perceiving things right now. I feel like the perception of what you're seeing right now isn't what it is. So if you're perceiving things as very serious or detrimental, it's not. Whatever you perceive it as is not. It's all an illusion. And I feel like it's time to realize, like, you can take a step back. You don't have to be so serious. You don't have to be so right all the time. It's so funny because I don't, personally, Gabrielle DeLaGarza doesn't see Sagittarius as seeing themselves as right all the time. But I feel like in this moment in time, that's how you feel. It's just right. Like, you're just right all the time. And in fact, you are. But there's also times where your opinions are right, but differentiated by other opinions can also be right. Which is why I feel like I need my glasses. Like, something about this whole reading, like, I needed my glasses. These aren't, like, prescription glasses. Like, I just needed to feel more intellectual. Like, there's a differential between you and other signs that are going on right now. Like, I keep saying like, but you want to be your own. I feel like there's a point in time where Sagittarius feels like the copycat, but they're not the copycat. They're the copyright. Like, you can't copy me. You can't be me. You can't do me. I am Sag. That's who I am. And that is right. Like, I feel like that's right. Like, exactly that. Like, Sagittarius is Sagittarius. They're not able to be copyrighted or copycatted. There's an emotional... an emotional tank right now. That's, like, being, like, held. Like, if... Now I understand why Aries and Sagittarius are being done at the same time. Besides the fact that they're both fire signs, I feel like Sagittarius is dealing with the same separation. Not anxiety within oneself, but I feel like there's a separation within oneself. Like, there's this emotional part of you that deals with the relationships that's, like, to the side, and then there's you. You're not, like, equating relationships with yourself the same as Aries. Like, as fire signs as a whole, I feel like there's a lot of... this is relationships, this is me. This is me, and this is me in relationships. Like, you're not the same person in both. And I think the best part of you is to be able to find that equilibrium between both. But I don't think you're ready... If you're not already in a relationship... I think it's best that you're not in a relationship because you have to find equilibrium between the two of you. You and Aries would do really well in a conversation right now because I feel like you have a lot of similarities going on. Like, the way I determine who's going is by what I feel, and the energy that came through was Sagittarius. And it wasn't necessarily Sagittarius that I wanted to do. Like, I kept wanting to do Cancer, actually, or Scorpio. Cancer, Scorpio. But then I realized it wasn't them. It was, which are both water signs, which is the opposite of you guys. It was Sagittarius. So you are being prominent. You are putting yourself out there right now. There's something that you're doing that's, like, not of the norm of you guys. And I feel like that's actually going to get you to where you need to be. So if you feel like you're not on the right path, I'm here to tell you that you are. Something about the uncomfortability of the path that you're about to embark on, which is new and different, is the right path. Something about this is right. Something feels right. something is exciting. And you're not alone. You feel alone. You're not alone. You're not alone at all. You'll never be alone. Just fight a little longer, my friend. It's all worth it in the end. Hold on and I'll find you. You need to keep pushing. You're very emotional right now. It's hard to tame. Sagittarius, I've never seen you this emotional before. But I feel like it's good. And you don't have to like show it off to everybody. You don't have to be like, oh, I'm emotional. Like, it's not about that with you. It's about like more of the internal, like, okay, this is what I feel. And I feel like you have control of it when you're alone. It's when other people get involved. Like, I feel like friends or family or whatever are like there's too many people in. Like, I feel like you need to almost block them off. Like, normally I would tell people, like, no, let people in. But for you, Sagittarius, I feel like you need to block it off and, like, be within yourself, because you're so spiritual that you can actually deal with your own inner feelings and be able to dissect them better by yourself than with other people. I feel like I get you. I feel like I understand the frustration of, like, not feeling okay, but, like, having everything be stable. Like, there's a stability to your life. And, like, things go astray sometimes, and it's hard to explain. Like, there's no reason to explain your astrays to anybody. They're just for you. They're not for other people. But I feel like sometimes you have a responsibility to say, oh, well, this is the reason why. Like, you don't need to tell people why. It's not their business. Sagittarius, I feel like you have complete control of your life. If you want it. Otherwise, you actually take your own control and put it in other people's hands, and then you blame them. Not blame, but you, like, make it their responsibility rather than taking on your own responsibility. You have more control of your life when you have your own responsibilities to take care of. I feel like, Sagittarius, you're good with or without somebody. And I feel like that's not something I could say to everybody. So whether you're with somebody right now, I feel like you know how to handle it. You do. You know how to be with that person. You know their ins and outs. You know you can read them. And if you're not with somebody, I feel like you are okay alone. Like, you can read yourself and you know why nobody has fit you so far. Don't feel weird about that. That's, like, the most perfect thing you could do is be single and love yourself and know that you're with yourself because nobody else is good enough to be with you. I mean, like, straight up. As a Sagittarius, you need somebody special. You need someone who gets you. You need someone who can handle the fire and the quirkiness. Sad, you're quirky. You're quirky. Quirk, quirk, quirk. No, but seriously, like, you have this quirk to you that's not of the norm. That's almost inexplainable. That's secret to you. That's undescribable by books, by tarot readers, by astrologers. It's just personal to who you are. Each and every individual Sagittarius that's out there. So if you're single, it's because that person hasn't found that quirk yet to you, or you haven't elaborated that to them. But if you haven't elaborated it to them, it's because you know better. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's this trust within the energy right now that I feel, that you know what you're doing. It's not that I have advice for you. It's more of confirmations. It's not like, oh, you should do this. It's no, what you're doing is okay, or how you're feeling is okay, or how you're interpreting the way things are going on in your life is okay. Everything is okay right now. You're perfect right now, the way that things are. And it's so serious, but it's so fun at the same time. Because if the person who could understand the seriousness of you would see right through it and get to the fun, and that person is going to be your soulmate. So the person who gets you for that is going to be the person you should really pay attention to. Just don't push them away. That's all. Don't push them away for seeing through your seriousness, which isn't a common thing for you. You know, like, you are fun, but you're also very rigid, and you also understand who you are, so it's hard for people to get through that. So just let the people who do get through that, give them a chance. It may not be of the norm or what you're used to. Don't be afraid. Let's confirm with a couple cards. I hope that made sense, Sag. I love you so much. I feel so super, like, superior with these glasses on with you guys. It's so funny. Two of Cups. I feel like, oh, you can't see. It's like you're perfect by yourself. You could do it by yourself. And if you're feeling trapped, you can still do it by yourself. Right. Like, you're focused on the pinnacles that you have in front of you. And taking a leap of faith, moving forward, not being afraid. Like, that's all that, like, you're perfectly perfect exactly where you are. It's like, I feel like I have no guidance to give you, because I feel like you know what you need to do. Like, there's nothing here that I need to say, because you got it. You know what I'm saying? It's like the reassurance that I have to say is that you got it. You got it. You're good. Take a leap of faith and do something new. That is the one advice I have to give you. And get out of a toxic relationship if that's what you're in. If something isn't making you happy right now, or it's, like, clearly toxic and it's not what is for you, get out. Move out. Even if it feels like what you're moving into is less, or even if it's moving back to your parents' house, or moving where you don't seem to have as much money because you're not with your partner, like, get out of it. You'll eventually end up with more, because you'll have less energetic toxicity pulling from you consistently, taking from the person that you are over time. And then eventually you're gonna be 40 and be like, oh my god, or 50 or 60 and be like, wow, what was I doing? I'm getting that someone definitely needs to leave their home situation for sure. Could be a marriage. I'm hearing marriage. Get out now while you can. It's gonna seem like a rough time, but you know what? The full moon's coming, and that is the time to do it. King of Pentacles. It's because he has money. You gotta get away from the factor of money and realize that you're okay without the money. The money will come and go. The Devil. You don't want to be tied to the Devil. Hangman. It's weird because, like, I didn't want to get into this, but I feel like I had to. So I feel like that's how you are, Sag. Like, you didn't want to get into this, but, like, you realize, like, that there's something out there that you had to get into, which was the fact that, like, you are in a toxic situation that needs to be stopped. And this isn't for all Sagittarius. It's just for the people who actually need it and have strength to move away, Sag, because you're the Empress. To get away from the devil energy. See, the devil just flew. He's not stronger than you. You need to have strength to move away and be the Empress. And that's it. Sag, I love you so much. I feel like this was so serious and so sexual. I feel like you're so sexy. I feel like the glasses make everything, and I just love you. All right, I hope you enjoyed. I hope you got messages from this, and I will see you soon. Bye, Sag.